Can you tell us more about your interview process or the task that was given to you for the internship at Urbit Lab?
Yeah, so I was given actually two projects there. So one of the project was redesigning their massage experience. I can't share the details for that project, but there's one more project that I worked on. It's a part of that project only, where my task was to design for the variants.
So this is the project that you had done while you were interning at Urbit Lab.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So my task was to design the to provide a card which can provide users the ability to add multiple variants in the product. So we started with this double diamond approach for the project, where we collected some data. We looked at how the pricing is done. So I will give you an example to explain what were these variants. So for their massage product, there was two type of variants. So there was one 60-minute, and then there was one 90-minute massage. So the pricing was different. But the idea was that if you booked a 90-minute massage, then you can get it at the affordable prices. So our task was to actually upsell this higher variant to the user. Then we looked at other products as well. So we started with first our initial product, how they were handling it. Initially, there used to be a different card variant for each of the variant. Like for example, Swedish massage, there was a 60-minute card and there was a 90-minute massage. So what happened is that it increased the size for the whole scrolling behavior. So we wanted to combine all these variants into one card. Then one more objective was to scale it for the other products as well, which was there was a spa product, then there was a carpet cleaning, and there were other products as well. So then we did a competitive study. We looked at how Amazon was doing it. So Amazon was also following the same criteria, where there was different cards for a different variant. And also the price comparison was very difficult, because you had to select each variant to find out the price for each variant. Similarly, Flipkart was doing this the same way. Then there was one more product which we looked at. I think this was Grofers. Then we identified where were these competitors lacking against our all objective, which was upselling the high price variant. So Amazon, Flipkart, and Grofers were treating all these variants same. Then there were different items, is the different variant available, of information shown on the card, is there a variant selection button. So there were too many of these factors. So then we started defining this problem statement into like a list of five small statements we created using a how might we method, where there were some business objectives, like how might we upsell the higher variant to the user, and at the same time we wanted to ensure that she is making a good deal on that product. Then there was some other problem statements also, like how we can give the ability to the user to select all the to view all the variants and select them, and how we can make it scalable. So these were some problem statements. Then we ideated on a very, very roughly on paper, and then we had a brainstorming session with all the team members. Then we created some of the different variations. We tried to question each and every variant. For example, we tried showing in a horizontal manner different and the price of the different variants. But then if a for a product, if there are many variant, then it will be not a good idea. So then similarly, we thought of different type of variants which can solve the process. Showing up offer card where we will upsell.
Can you repeat your statement after variant? There was some internet lag, that's why.
Okay, sorry. From here?
Yeah.
Okay. So for each problem statement, we iterated, we created multiple variations and we kind of questioned each and every variation. So one of the variation was showing all the variants in a horizontal list view. But the problem with this view was that for a product, if we have like more than two or three variants, then it will be difficult for a user to view each of them. Then similarly, we again tried showing a banner for it. But again, there were some problems with it. I will not go in much detail because it will be too long. So I'll just keep it short. So then we finally ended up with showing a banner for it. Then similarly, there was this problem of when we decided what information we want to show. Like there were different elements in the card, like price, these details, the quantity, and what variant you have selected. So we actually struggled a lot on defining how the price should be. Should we show it in a range, or if when we are showing it in a range, should we show it per category wise? Like for example, if you are buying a product for per person, then how the price will be?
Right.
Then we finally ended up showing that we'll show a lower product or lower price only, because if we show higher price, then it might lead to a drop off. So we showed a lower price, but we showed also the variant and showed a arrow which can let the user to select other variants as well. So this was it. Then we tried to we designed the variant selection flow, which was basically if you tap on this arrow, then there will be a card which comes up where you can select each of the variant. Here also you can select multiple variants. For example, if you want to book like a 60 minute massage plus 90 minute massage, you can do it all together. Or if basically it was dependent on our product, that if the product wants to allow selection of multiple variant, then he can allow that. Otherwise, he can just disable it. So this was the idea. Then we scaled it for other variants also. Like for example, for a salon product which provided hair color option, we tried to club all these variants into categories. For example, for brown color, for black color, and so this was it. So yeah, this was all about the project. So there was some very good lessons that I learned from this project, that sometimes we were debating too much about business needs and user needs. Then we figured out that we cannot let one win over the other, because these two have to work in harmony to produce the design. Then also breaking down the objective into set of these five problem statements really helped us, because then we had a clear goal on to solve each of the problems separately. And we were able to come up with different variations for each of the problem. Then there was one more situation when we were trying to design for a edge case. But while designing for the edge case, we kind of converted this whole variation flow into a flow which treated this edge case as the primary flow. So we learned that we cannot make that flow, because a edge case is a flow which is used by a very less number of the users. And so we should treat these edge cases only, and should not have put too much focus and investment onto it.
Right.
So yeah, this was all about this project.
Nice.